Welcome, everyone. This is Kiana from ThisIsR&B.com. Today, we are joined with the two-time Grammy-nominated Billboard Music NAACP Image Award-winning artist, Corinne Hawthorne. Oh, my gosh. Welcome to ThisIsR&B.com.
How you doing, girl?
I'm awesome. Excited to talk to you, and I know the fans want to hear what you have to say. So yeah. How do you feel when you hear an introduction like that? How does that make you feel?
Like it's not me, to be honest with you. I'd be like, who did what? Yeah, so I don't know. I'm like super grateful. I think that, you know, accomplishments are like really dope. People try to be humble about it, but it's just like, come on, man. Like, I've been wanting to sing since I was a kid, so it feels really good. Like, even though I don't feel like it's me, it feels good. So glory to God. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes. And that is all you, girl. That voice.
Oof. Thank you.
You're welcome. So tell us a little bit about who Corinne is.
Corinne is a girl, country girl from Louisiana. I've been singing ever since I was 7 years old. Some people may know me from The Voice. I did that in 2015 and made it all the way to the finals on Team Pharrell. From there, just continued on my path that God had for me, got signed to my label and released a song called Won't He Do It. So some of you may know me as Miss Won't He Do It. Yes. And even from there, just continuing to grow. I'm 22 years old and, you know, I love to sing. It's my passion, but I'm about purpose. And I'm just about doing exactly what God is calling me to do. And I think that's to inspire people. That is to give them relatable circumstances and hopefully to help them through situations in their lives through music. So yep, that's me, girl. If I had to describe me, that's what I would say.
Okay, all right. So I saw you on The Voice. I remember The Voice days. I believe Christina Aguilera was the first person to turn around for you.
Well, that was my first judge. Yeah.
And then Pharrell turned around for you at the last minute, and you ultimately ended up going with Christina Aguilera. Like, how, in that moment, what made you just decide to just stick with Christina?
I think because, like, beforehand, I told myself that, like, you know, I'm going to listen to what they say and whoever, like, speaks to my heart in the moment the best is who I'm going to choose. And Christina just kept on talking about, like, how she sings things that she feels. She wants to feel connected to the things that she sings. And that was me all day, is I'm not going to sing nothing that I don't feel. So I just was like, those are keywords. So I'm gonna go with you, sis. And it didn't work out. I ended up changing to Team Pharrell, but I think, again, like, it just was like a God moment for me because she was great. And then going to him was just like, I needed this too. So it was dope to have them, you know, as both my coaches throughout that process. So shout out to Christina Aguilera, shout out to Pharrell Williams, and shout out to the whole Voice family. I love y'all forever.
Absolutely. So when you first go on the show, you kind of have it in your mind, like, if these people turn around, I'm going to go with X, Y, and Z. And then in that moment, you just listen to what they have to say, and then you let, I guess, the spirit.
Yeah, your heart decide for you. You know, I think that that's the best thing to do it. Yeah.
So from The Voice to now, what would you say is your most greatest accomplishment in the music industry?
Grammy nominations. Like, I think that that's the biggest thing that you can get. Hopefully, you know, one day I'll be blessed enough to actually receive an award. But like, I got a Grammy nomination on my first single, and to me it's just like, what? Like, that's really dope. That's everything that I've dreamed of ever since I was a little girl. So the Grammy nominations would probably have to be top of my list. Y'all see my gold record plastered in the back. I am not trying to.
This is my house.
Y'all in my house now. This is how I got my house. It's the best part of my house. So I'm showing y'all the best part. So yeah, gold record is actually really cool because that just shows that people actually went out and like bought the record. Like, so I don't know. Those are like really dope accomplishments for me.
Yeah, people are definitely going to go out and buy your stuff. They really, truly mess with you. Like, you are a dope artist. Your voice is sick. Listen, if I had those awards, I have them all around here, too. So,
I'm gonna get there one day. Right? Like, I have been to, like, so many different, like, producers' homes and, like, artists' homes. And you walk in and their house is plastered and you, like, this is what I want for myself one day. And my house isn't plastered. But I got a few, and I'm like, I can only imagine and hope and want for more. But, you know, I'm just grateful to be able to do what I do. You know, like, this is dope. This is fun. I'm not going to lie to you. It's fun.
Oh, yeah. And it's fun watching you. And you're going to get there. Trust me. You're a powerful singer. Where does that power come from? And where does it take you?
Yeah, definitely. This is foundational. I was born and raised in a church in the middle of a cane field in Louisiana. And definitely, like, it's the people who came before me. They basically, like, passed this mantle down over to me. My strength, my mama, like, just so many different. I would have to say it comes from the people before me. It's inherited. So I'm grateful to my family for accepting that, accepting the call of God over their lives, and, you know, passing it down through the bloodline. And it just came, you know, it came to me. So thank you, Jesus. So, yeah, shout out to them. Shout out to my family.
Okay, so do you have any, or are there any other singers in your family?
Definitely, my dad's side, they're full of singers, full of talented singers. Not so much on my mom's side, but she is, it's so crazy. She the person that, like, stepped up and was like, let's do this. But, you know, on my dad's side, full of singers, full of talented artists.
Okay, and I see you're very close with your mom from your Instagram. I saw that she has surgery. Is she okay?
Yeah, she is doing okay. The surgery was successful. I think that this is just a step in the right direction. She kind of was dealing with pain and inflammation in her body. She has lupus and struggles with arthritis. So we're grateful to God, like, for the surgery, and hopefully it's a process of making things get better. So y'all just keep her in y'all prayers, but we're happy about a successful surgery.
Absolutely. Won't he do it?
And he will all the time, girl. You already know that.
I'm not going to start singing, but when it comes to stuff like that, you know, you got to give them glory, right? You're releasing your sophomore album Friday. So let's talk about it. Let's tell everybody about this new album coming out.
September the 18th, which is tomorrow. Lord have mercy. I am really excited about this. I worked really hard on this album. But it was easy, despite, you know, me being in the studio long hours. This was an easy album to create because I feel like it was super raw and organic. And I think that God was in the center of it. Like, we did this before, you know, the pandemic, before these issues came. And we have songs in this album that, like, specifically relate to the things that we're going through right now. So I think for me, that's what's important, is that we're actually making impactful music that'll, like, impact people's lives. Because, you know, you can make music to uplift and inspire, but I don't think it's too often that you're making music for the times that everybody's going through at the same time, and we all need this message. So I'm really excited about the album, and I'm excited about the people that I worked with on this album. Shout out to DJ Camper, who produced a lot of songs on this record. Troy Taylor, Jonte Austin. It's just an amazing record, and I'm really proud of it, and I'm excited to release it.
I'm excited too. I can't wait. So talk about some of the artists that you work with. Do you have any other artists that are on your wish list to collaborate with?
Definitely. A few people I think that I want to collaborate with. Would love to do something with her in the future. I think that she's really dope and also has, like, some of the same values and standards as I. So I think that we would create something super dope. I don't know, Kirk Franklin, of course. I love Kirk Franklin.
Yes.
So it's like, I'll be telling him, you better write me a song, sir. I'm not playing with you. So yeah, those are just, you know, two off the top of my head, but definitely have more.
Okay. All right. So we have her and Kirk Franklin.
Yeah.
You hear that? We need to make that happen. I would love to hear that. Okay. Okay. So who are some of your gospel mentors?
I said him all top. I went on tour with him last year, and he's just somebody that I've looked up to ever since I was a kid, but also to meet him in person and know that he's, like, supportive and a fan of my music and kind of just, like, hands-on and, like, whatever you need, anything you need to know, like, I got you. That's everything to me. So he's going to be at the top of my list forever because he's in real life there and supportive. And shout out to Mary, who I love and adore and have been looking up to since I was a kid. Erica Campbell, Tina Campbell. I was on their reality show a few years ago, so they allowed me to be on there and kind of get exposure. So much love to them. These are people who are actually in real life, like, have showed me love and support. So Donnie McClurkin, who I have a sample of one of his songs on my album, so he approved that. So these are just a few people who I love and adore in real life. So shout out to them.
Okay, so how does that make you feel, you know, being a young child, looking up to these artists, and now you're actually working with them, hanging out with them, you know, learning from them? How does that feel?
I think I feel blessed, but at the same time, it's kind of like, you know, now that I'm here and I get it, like, I guess some people, like, are about like clout and just like the wrong intentions, but like I'm all about like truthfully, like I said, Kirk is like the most down to earth person that you'll ever meet, besides the fact that he's Kirk Franklin to me. It's just like, it's, you know, it's Uncle Kirk, like, you know. So I think that that's really dope that when you meet people in real life that they're actually real people. And yeah, I can only be grateful to God for this experience, because I know a lot of people don't have that. So I'm grateful that they look at me as somebody to invest their time in. So shout out to them. I love y'all.
So how are you moving through COVID-19 without touring and doing all the things you love to do? How's that for you?
It's a little bit of a struggle. I think it's an adjustment for sure. But we're all making adjustments. So I try not to too much think about that, because I know that some people are in worse positions than I am. So I just try to stay positive and also like see what part I could play in this. And that's why I'm grateful to be able to release an album during this time, because I'm offering some type of hope and inspiration to people. And that makes me feel like I'm doing something rather than just sitting down and complaining about it. You know, I get to play a part in making it better. So that's how I feel. That's what my mind is on. And I'm trying to stay positive with that idea. But it sucks. This year is sucky.
It is. But you do keep a positive outlook. I, like I said, I looked on your social media pages. And you wrote a quote on there. And you said, I hope this album turns your heart towards God, that you go deeper and discover him. You will discover yourself. I was like, okay.
You were like, and bars.
Yes, you're spitting bars. That was really, really deep. I was like.
When you just said it, I was like, I said that?
You said that. You also said, align our vision. It said, align our vision further. Give us identity in this season. I am who you say I am. Boldly, confidently, respectfully. I was like, she is preaching. Yeah. She is preaching. Yeah. I love it. Keep giving people inspiration, because a lot of people look to you, all generations, and definitely can help somebody.
Yeah, thank you. I really appreciate that. I think that that's what it's about for me, is it's about purpose. And it might sound cliche, but I promise you, like, I would not be happy, like, doing anything else. The call of God over my life is like super important, and the call over God's life, you know, for everybody is super important. So I think that that's what's my job, is to hopefully like show people that like when you respond to the call, it's the best decision ever, and hopefully pull that out of people, that everybody would be in the I am season of their life, that you are who God called you to be, and you boldly and confidently and respectfully walk in that, because that's all he wants from us. So yeah.
I'm walking in it.
Please walk in it.
So tell us what's next for Corinne.
What is next for Corinne? I don't know. You know, I didn't think that this was what was next for Corinne. So whatever God wants for me is what's next for me. I have desires. I want to be a part of TV and film, and hopefully, you know, do some movies, because I've been dramatic since I was a child. So it would be such a waste of this dramatic talent. You know what I mean? So that's just something that I'm into. I really love cooking. Like, hopefully I can like write a cookbook and be on a food channel. Like, these are just some of my desires. I want to be, you know what? I want to be on Guys Grocery Games. I want to be a judge on Chopped. Okay. I can taste y'all food. I like to eat. So
are you going to be one of those rough judges like, this is nasty. Get out of here.
Now you know that's what I'm going to do, because I ain't go to culinary school or nothing like that. So I'm just tasting it with a normal taste bud.
Okay.
It's nasty. I ain't really like it.
Oh, man. And that's the one thing about you. I see you keep it real. You
keep it raw. That's what they want to see. Exactly. Everybody don't want all of that. I'm going to be the real person to be like, oh, what a season. Baby, I wish y'all would have added a little bit more seasoning today. It's good, but we could have had a little bit more salt, pepper, little Creole seasoning would have popped this dish right out the top, but it was good though.
Oh my gosh, where's the hot sauce? I can totally see you acting. I really can. Your personality, you have a personality for it, for real.
For sure.
All right, so do you want to sing a little something for the people?
I'll sing Won't You Do It, because I feel like that's the only thing they want to hear.
They want to hear Won't You Do It. They definitely do. And then you can sing a little something from your new album.
So I'll give y'all a snippet. Won't you do it? Said you would. Fight your battles for you. They gon' wonder how you sleep at night. Won't you do it? Yes, he will. Anybody tell you something different, you know that's a lie. You gonna look back and be so amazed how it turned out. It's only his grace. Won't he do it? I know he will. So I trust him at all times. Hey.
Won't he do it? Yes. Won't he do it?
I want to wake up to you every day. I think I feel like this forever. As long as we're together, want to know you each and every way. I promise to be honest when I speak to you. Want to put you at the top of my list. Want to walk it like I talk it. Want to give you everything. Please tell me that you're rocking with this. You know all the ways to speak to me. And y'all better be glad because I'm a little stocked up.
You still sound amazing.
Thank you.
That was definitely a blessing. Thank you so much for, you know, coming in, blessing us with your voice, giving us a little taste of who Corinne is.
Yeah.
Tell the people where they can find you.
Y'all can follow me on all socials at Corinne Hawthorne. That's Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. This new album can be streamed on all streaming platforms, wherever you buy your music at, Apple Music, iTunes, Amazon Music, Google Play. Go and get this music. And then y'all hit me up on social media and let me know what y'all think. Let me know what y'all favorite song is. I want to know. I love to know. Thank you so much, girl. You're dope.
You heard the woman. Go out, stream it, buy it, support her in every way possible. She's worth it. She's dope, y'all. Come on, go out there.
I mean, just go check it out. Don't like it, just go check it out.
You need the supporter. Thank you so much, Corinne, for coming and sharing your time with us and sharing your talent with us. We are so blessed we got to hear you. Thank you guys for tuning in today. We'll see you next time. Telling you my issues, you keep it official every time I kick it with you. Come back and visit us. Don't forget about us. You know,
girl, I'm coming back.
And the cooking shows.
Listen, look at my dog just waking up. Like, girl, what you doing? Thank you, girl. I will be back. All right.
Okay. And give your mom our love. We hope she
Thank
has
you.
A fast
I
recovery.
Appreciate that so much. All right. I'll let her know.
Okay, we love you.
Love you guys. Thank you.
Bye.